a state championship is an outstanding accomplishment for any school. But winning two state titles in 1 year is truly remarkable. That's what Fall Creek High School has done. The Cricket boys basketball team won its second Class C title. And only 1 week earlier, the Fall Creek girls team won its own championship. Two state titles in 2 weeks.
We do have great tradition, you know, of winners breed winners.
I worked with Ron for many years, and I know what kind of perfectionist he is. And it pushes me to try to get to that level.
I'm Rick Boyd, and this is the story of Fall Creek's two 1985 champions, the boys and girls basketball teams, in the year of the cricket. Fall Creek High School. From the outside, there doesn't appear to be anything too different about it. It's what's inside that's special. Inside, there are two state championship basketball teams. In short, Fall Creek High School is the home of winners.
These kids represent us in athletics or forensics or drama or whatever, want to do the best they can. And it's just something that's ingrained, you know, I think from their folks and from the situation. You know, when the kids do something here, in school, whether it be a dance or organize a snow fest, they ask me about it, and I say, yes, the only thing you do now, you do it well. Do it the first time well, and you'll be happy. So they organize it well, and then we're all happy.
That winning attitude is reflected in the Fall Creek trophy case. This year, for example, the Cricket's athletic teams have won conference titles in football, volleyball, boys basketball, and girls basketball.
Now you gotta have desire and, I just say attitude, because if you don't have good attitude, you're not gonna be winners. You can't have a negative attitude about things.
We have good coaches, and we never think of losing. It's always, we're gonna win.
There isn't much else to do around Fall Creek except practice. I mean, if we were in Eau Claire, we'd have other things to do, but in summer, we just play basketball and practice playing basketball.
The community sport, you know, all through the years that I've been in high school, you know, it's just been tremendous. I thought, you know, it's really been great compared to the other schools around that are our size, you know. I thought that ours was really special. The fans were really good to the players. They really didn't get on them like they do at some schools, you know. And, you know, they understand, you know, you're not going to win every game.
It must be wanting to do as good as the team the year before or something, but everybody works during the summers and they get good and they come back to compete.
I think we've experienced success and we know how good we have to play in order to achieve that. I think it just carries through.
One of the biggest reasons that you know, we stayed wasn't that, hey, we're going to have great teams and so on, because we didn't at that time. But one of the biggest reasons we stayed, we liked the school system, the community, and we felt it would be a real good place to bring up our kids.
Our staff here, and since I've been here 11 years now, we've turned over 4 people. Now, that's a remarkable. These people want to have their kids go to school at Fall Creek. I want my sons to go to Fall Creek High School. So that's bottom line.
The Fall Creek girls basketball team set a goal after last season: go out this year and have the greatest season in school history. That goal was reached, and then some. Bob Raynard has this look at the Fall Creek girls' drive to the state title.
The cricket season really began after winning their first 8 games. Game number 9 came against Owen Withy, a team Fall Creek fought and battled just to stay alive. The last gasp came at the free throw line, and just like that, it was over. The Cricket's own holiday tournament brought no presents this year, but that loss set the stage for a championship season.
As we look down the season and the way we used it, I think it had a huge impact, because any time that the kids started not being up for a ball game or playing poorly in the first half, you just had to say to them, hey, remember a game back around Christmas time and how much it hurt to lose that type of ball game if you didn't put in a real good effort. And I think psychologically it probably had a lot to do with our season.
Regardless of the girls' success, this school has always been a boys' basketball powerhouse. The girls were shadows of the boys, never sharing in the spot.
So it was a constant pressure. We were doing really good, and we kept saying, well, we're going to state. And the guys going, no, you guys can't handle the pressure. You won't go to state. So that kind of made us want to go even more.
The winning never stopped. First, Augusta fell in the opening round of sub-regionals, followed by a win over Oliva Strum. 2 days later, they beat Cadott in regionals. But the biggest challenge was still yet to come.
I think we all set goals because we knew we had a good basketball team coming back. For me, no. I never even thought about it because I knew there was a big obstacle in the way, namely Pepin. I knew they would have a good basketball team coming back, and I knew that whatever was going to be done had to go through them.
Undefeated Pepin went down in the regional final. In sectionals, Bangor was the opponent, a team they knew little about. Led by Sandy Eiler's 16 points, the Crickets moved into the sectional final with a 53-45 win. La Crosse was the site, Ithaca the challenge, and a freshman named Jan Zimmerman came off the bench to spark a fourth quarter surge and put it out of reach. The final, Fall Creek 55, Ithaca.
Because I couldn't picture us losing. At first it didn't hit you, it didn't seem real. I couldn't believe we were actually going to state because every game we played, it just seemed like a regular game. It didn't seem like we were really going to the state championship tournament, you know. It was relief that we had gotten there, and we were really happy, and everybody was just all this attention all of a sudden.
But the attention wouldn't stop there. In the semifinal, Abbotsford gave the Crickets all they could handle, but it was Eilers and Zimmerman in the second half that made the difference. In the championship, Fall Creek dominated Turtle Lake. They held the Lakers to just 11 points in the entire first half. Eilers had 16 points, Wilbur 12, and the 33-point margin made a clear cut where the Class C champions were. For most, the feeling still has not sunk in yet.
It's still hard for, I think, our girls to realize that they've done something probably a little special. And it is special, and I think once they get away from it a little bit, they'll realize how special it was.
It kind of hit me back when we got into the hotel, but I don't think I've felt the full impact of it yet. When we were in the locker room, they put the gold ball up on the table, and we were all looking at it. That's when it really sunk in. There's a feeling of, you don't have to prove yourself anymore. You're there, and you won the first game, so you're going to be taking something home for sure, and you have a feeling of, wow, now I can go home and take that reception with something. I guess the greatest feeling was knowing that we finally accomplished something as good as the guys.
And the welcome home celebration was as good as the guys. It was special, because this time, for the first time, the girls were the ones on center stage, and the cricket pride shown the boys was as green as ever. No longer will the girls just watch from the stands. No longer will they wonder what winning a championship is like. The shadows are gone in Fall Creek. These girls truly earned their own identity.
Of course, that was the first of two championships for the Crickets. When we return, we'll profile the boys' team, a state champ again. The Fall Creek boys' basketball team had a couple of tough acts to follow this year. Not only did last year's Crickets win a state title, but the Fall Creek girls were champs too. The Cricket boys were up to both challenges.
This year's championship season actually started last year. The Crickets won their first state Class C title. They set the standard for this season. And this year's Crickets were determined to reach the same goal. But at the beginning, there were doubts.
Yeah, there were doubts in my mind. I didn't think we were going to be state champions again. I don't think no one did because of our height and... But Mr. Schultz, if you work hard on defense and work the ball on offense and
have discipline, we'll be okay.
Never expected something like that, and I think a coach would be very foolish to even think that, you know, hey, we're the state champion. You've got that possibility in your mind, and you work towards those goals, but I think if a guy expected it, he would probably ended up very disappointed in most cases.
Many of the doubts were cleared up in the first game of the year. A very highly regarded Elk Mound team came to Fall Creek, and the Crickets, the new Crickets, answered the challenge, 57-48. Another championship season was underway.
Yeah, in the beginning of the season, they got us off started on the right foot. We knew we had something, you know, maybe Elk Mound, because they were supposed to be highly rated.
When we changed our defense in practice, we didn't know, I don't know, how it would work. We were kind of surprised. But then after we beat them, we knew it was a good defense, and we had our confidence built up. We knew we could beat anybody then.
And the Crickets played that way. They went on a roll, winning their first seven games, part of a 32-game winning streak. But something unusual happened on the way to their own holiday tournament title. The Crickets lost to Spooner.
That you'd see in the papers, and you would hear it sometimes from people downtown or in Eau Claire, you know, how many wins in a row. I don't know what it got to, 32 or whatever. And yeah, it was kind of a pressure reliever. The loss, it can go back to, you know, we played a team with superior height and played a good zone against us, and they really cut us off.
When we lost this point, you know, we looked at it as a learning experience. You know, we realized, you know, that we could lose, you know, if we have a bad night. And we played a really good team. And, you know, if you lose, you lose. You know, let's just go back, you know, and try to do your best.
The Crickets did not lose again. They sailed through the Clover Belt Conference unbeaten for the second year in a row. They did it with quickness. They did it with hard work. They did it with defense.
We tried to go into a defense that would give us that ability, and thankfully, Dick Bennett, you know, he has his pressure man-to-man, and we kind of designed ours after the Stevens Point defense, and it helped tremendously.
Fall Creek was obviously the team to beat come tournament time, but the Crickets refused to be stopped. And Fall Creek's best player, Coda, saved his best for the biggest games of the year. Against Elk Mound, he scored 42 points.
Most of the games, you know, I only had about, you know, 14, 16 points. And, but for some of the big games, you know, my name just got thrown in because I had a couple big games this year. And I think that's the way it should be, though. Everybody, you know, but when we played our best is when we had balanced scoring.
No, you have to give Mark credit. In a few of the big games we had where some of the guys just didn't seem to get going, the ball wasn't going in the bucket, he was able to hold us in until we got things straightened out. Now three times he scored over 30 in a ball game. They were all important ball games. But you go back to the other way, they're going to have to, you know, shut down three or four in any one night. They could not zero in and take picks at Coda or John. And so it made it difficult to defend against us.
Of course, there was even more incentive in the tournaments this year. The other Fall Creek team, the girls' team, had come home with a state championship of its own.
Every day, even the regular season, we were saying, girls won, we're going to win. We're not going to lose, because if we came back to school, we'd never hear the end of it. And then in the state tournament, they won the state tournament, and we said, we got to win again, else we'd never hear the end of it.
We wanted to be just as good as the girls. Didn't want to let the girls show us up. And winning last year, everybody, I don't know, since eighth grade, they said that we'd be the year to go to Madison. They weren't expecting last year, but after they did last year, they really wanted to see us go and win it twice.
The Crickets didn't let anybody down. They went back to Madison for the third year in a row. The Crickets' first-round opponent, Glidden. Glidden was unbeaten, big, and leading at halftime.
Well, I thought that we could come back, but it's going to be rough. We have to work hard. We've been down a lot this year at halftime by 10, 12 points, and we've always come back, so I knew that if we just work hard, we could come back and do it.
Generally, we don't change. You know, we just say, what are we going to do the second half? We're going to do the same thing. Let's hopefully we're going to do a little better. And Maybe we can familiarize them a little better with what's going on in the game and so on. But there hasn't been any great major changes. I can't take credit for any halftime overhauls to turn things around.
The second half put Glidden away and put Fall Creek in the state championship game. Three straight years the Crickets have played in that title game. It was time once again for the Fall Creek experience to really come through.
The coach, you know, kind of mentally prepares us for the game, you know. Before we even left for the state tournament, he told us, you know, just remember that, you know, it's just a game, you know, don't think about the cameras, you know, and all the media. Just go out there and play your ball. Just pretend, you know, like it's an away game.
And Mr. Schultz, before every game, he goes, go out, have some fun. It's just another game. He said that before every game, and we did.
It's always more fun when you win. The Crickets dominated Oakfield in the second half and won going away, 78-54. The new Crickets had proven they deserve to be champions too.
They've always been able to come through. It's a great winning attitude. I think they know how to win, and you know, they know that they have to put in their time. You know, you say if you want somebody, we really want the guy that has the ability. He wants to win. Well, everybody wants to win. Where these kids, I think, they wanted to win. They're willing to put in their time to prepare themselves to win, and I think they prepared themselves well throughout the years.
John Whitworth, Dwayne Deccan, Kerry Reitz, Dennis Deccan, and Mark Coda. The starting lineup for the Crickets, two-time state champs.
The green and white are our school colors, and I don't think there's any one of us that don't wear them with pride. Our pride is all over the state of Wisconsin. There isn't any place that can't locate Fall Creek right now. They're having a hard time with Eau Claire, but they know where Fall Creek is.
The Fall Creek basketball season was amazing, but there were other area teams which also had outstanding seasons. We'll take a look at those teams when we come back. For the year, the Fall Creek boys and girls combined to win 52 games. They lost only two. Fall Creek became only the school to ever win both the girls and boys state titles in one year. But other area teams won their way to the state tournament too. One of those teams was Eau Claire North in Class A. The Huskies had their greatest season ever, making it to Madison for the first time in the school's 23-year history. The Huskies lost in the first round of the tournament to eventual state Class A champion Milwaukee Washington. But that loss couldn't take away a 19-4 season record and Big Rivers and sectional championships. A great season for the Huskies under second-year head coach Pat Hammond. The year was a first for Osseo Fairchild, too. The Chieftains qualified for state for the first time since the school district was consolidated. Osseo Fairchild lost its only two games before Christmas and was never stopped until the state tournament's first round. Prairie du Chien knocked out the Chiefs, who finished 21-3 overall. John Pollock of Durand led his girl Panthers to another Middle Border Conference championship and another trip to Madison. Durand had lost only once before state, but the Panthers ran into a powerful Waterford team and their season was over. Of course, not every team can be a state champ. But each of those teams we just looked at were winners, true winners. We have a salute to all of the state tournament teams from our area. Here's to the winners.
Here's to the winners. Lift up the glasses. Here's to the glory still to be. Here's to the battle, whatever it's for, to our ask the best of ourselves, then give much more. Here's to the heroes, those who move mountains. Here's to the miracles they make us see. Here's to all brothers. Here's to all people.
It has been our pleasure covering all of the area high school teams this past season. Congratulations to all of them for a fine year. A year that really belongs to the two Fall Creek champions, the year of the cricket. Thank you for joining us.